Good day, everyone. Saturday, the 8th of August, 2020. My name is Jewel, and this is J7409 Weather. We're going to check out everything real quick pertaining to the weather. Here we go at the National Hurricane Center, where we have this disturbance number one. It's still just a tropical wave, folks, several hundred miles west-southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands. Now, it is producing some showers and thunderstorms, and just a little bit slight development of the system is possible during the next day or so. It's moving really slowward to the westward areas. After that time, it's not going to do a lot, folks, I do not think at this time. The environmental conditions are expected to become less conducive for development, and as you can see, in 2 days and 5 days, we have a low 10% chance of it developing. If anything comes out of it, I'll be sure and let you know. Looking like it's going to be a rainmaker mostly. Maybe Puerto Rico, a little bit of Dominican Republic and down on the islands. That's what it's looking like now. I'll keep my eyes on this system as well as all the others that will be coming off the coast in a week or so, and I will keep everyone informed for the Gulf states up and down the eastern seaboard. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. I will keep you up to date and let you know on a daily basis about severe weather for the most part. Of course, if we have a tropical storm or a hurricane, I have to devote most of my time to that. But so far as severe weather goes today, here we go. It's looking like we do have the strong to severe storms that are expected, so be on the lookout, especially if you're in South Dakota, this portion of Minnesota, a little bit of Ohio, and in Nebraska. Also, the outline in green, you could have a very good chance, even if it's at 1, this is at a 2, and be on the lookout, because these storms should happen this evening. It's when they should start into the overnight hours tonight. Now, severe wind gusts and large hail are looking like the main hazards, but there is a possibility of some tornadoes. As we look at the tornado outlook, it's at 2%. Nebraska, a little bit of northeastern Iowa, down in Minnesota in this area, in the western quadrant, and also in South Dakota. You could have some tornadoes, so please be on the outlook for that. Now, when it comes to the wind, most severe wind will be in Nebraska, the very same area, moving up into western Minnesota, South Dakota, and northeastern Iowa. And so far as the wind goes, looks like most of the bad damaging winds that could occur, and they're up to 15%. You might want to bring your stuff in so it don't blow away or tie it down with some wind gust, mainly in Nebraska and also in South Dakota. Thank each of you for watching. Please, if you haven't subscribed, please do so. Click subscribe, click the bell, and then check off all to ensure you get all my latest videos as I put them out. I will do my best to try to keep you informed with the up-to-date weather and what you can expect. Thank you to all my new subscribers and all of my old subscribers. Thank you so much. And for everything you guys do for me, I appreciate it greatly. Now, as we take a look at the NAM map, this is courtesy of Tropical Tidbits, and it will take us through today through Tuesday, so you guys will know what's coming up for the next few days as it's looking right now. You can see your time stamp up here, right here, as it moves through. We do have some storm systems that are going to be coming down from Canada and affecting parts of Canada. You'll probably see this low right here is going to form. It could get kind of strong as it moves up into Canada. So let's turn it on, and for the lower 48 today, I'm going to tell you what's happening. There is a slight risk, as I've showed you, of very severe thunderstorms over parts of the northern and central plains. In addition, the thunderstorm activity likely Sunday from the northern plains into the upper Great Lakes. And that fire weather risk is continuing for the northern high plains and the portions of the Rockies and the Great Basins. Now, a threat of isolated flash flooding. It's going to continue this afternoon into the evening across portions of the Mid-Atlantic, where flash flood watches are in effect right now, and thunderstorms will, however, be less numerous and less well organized than they have been for the last several days. Boy, oh boy, did I have some severe lightning for hours on hours last night. Had some rain, but it was more severe lightning than anything else. Now, the first of the two well-defined fronts that are going to move across the northern tier of the country, it's going to support the potential for severe thunderstorms today over the northern and central plains and into parts of the mid-Mississippi Valley. By Sunday and Monday, the second of the two fronts moving across the northern tier, it's going to support additional thunderstorm activity from the plains toward the upper Great Lakes and the western Ohio Valley. Now, the combination of this low relative humidity that's going on and the windy conditions over the western section of the U.S. and the northern high plains, it's going to continue to keep this risk of rapid wildfire spread if any fires should start. Lightning can start these, throwing something out of your window. Please be careful, folks. We do have some wildfires going on now, as everyone knows, and we don't need any more. And that's the check of your weather today. Thank you so much for watching, sharing this information. So far as tropical weather goes, do not fear. I will keep you up to date on it, okay? I promise. As you know, I live in Hurricane Alley myself. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day, and may each and every one of you have peace, love, and kindness in your lives today. Thanks for watching.